Hello friend, today we'll discuss about the legal terms. And today in this class we will discuss the terms, legal terms that starts with letter A. So let's start. And these videos are particularly beneficial for them, those who are preparing for the exam CLAT and other law entrance exam. So let's begin our class. So first term we are seeing, that is the abate. So what is an act of abatement? Act of abatement means to assist or aid in a commission of crime. When there is a crime has been committed, and someone or the some person, he is assisting the other person to for the commission of the crime. So the assisting person or the aiding person who is helping the other person to commit a crime, that person is called the abater. And the act, his act is called the abatement. So he is ultimately doing what? That person is helping. Who is an offender? He is helping an offender or a criminal. Now next legal term we have, that is an abortion. So what is an abortion? Abortion means an artificial termination of pregnancy. Abortion is permitted only if done under the advice of legal practitioners. Otherwise, it is an offense. So only the medical practitioners have the having the license of giving advice when to terminate the abortion, and the permission will be only will be given by the medical practitioners. Otherwise, if you don't take the advice of the medical practitioners, then in that case there will be the offense, that will lead to an offense. So abortion is that term. In medical term and in legal term, we use the abortion. Means abortion is an artificial, so abortion is a natural thing, but if that is done under the advice of a medical practitioner, then that will not be count as an offense. But if it is done artificially, if you terminate that, then that will lead to an offense. So that is an abortion. Now next word is the absconding. Absconding means to hide oneself, to escape arrest, or to avoid legal proceedings. So absconder is that person who is trying to avoid the legal proceedings, who are escaping from the arrest. So what happens generally, we see when a person who has committed a crime, after the commission of the crime, he generally runs away from the crime scene. So why he do that? He escapes the, his motive is to escape the arrest or to avoid the legal proceeding. So those who do that, they are called the absconder. So this is the term about the absconding. Next legal term is an absolute liability. So what act is then called the absolute liability? It is, it comes under, generally it comes under the law of tort. Means we in a legal course, we generally study the law of tort. Yes, legal tort or law of tort. So the that means that a person is absolutely liable for any injury or loss caused to his neighbors if he has stored something hazardous on his land for industrial use. Let me give an example about this absolute liability. So the person is A. A person having a storage house where he is storing some hazardous or a dangerous articles that are basically used for industrial use. So if any incident, any untoward incident happens, and that things, that industrial materials explodes, and it causes injury or loss to his neighbors, then that will be counted as an absolute liability in case of A. In that case, because of the carelessness of A, that has been happened, that incident, that untoward incident has been happened. So that is called absolute liability. Next is the absolute privilege. In judicial and parliamentary proceedings, judges and the members of parliament and in state legislature also can't be sued for defamation for statements made by them in their official capacity. It is then power they enjoy. The judges of the courts and also the member of parliament and also the representatives in the state legislatures, they enjoy a power that is an absolute in nature. And in that case, as they have the that immunity power, they have they do possess that immunity power, and that immunity power protects them from any defamation charge. If they, in any statement made by them, in there is something defamatory things are attached, yes, in that case, you can't sue him, that person. You can't sue a judge. You can't sue an MP or the member of the state legislature, because they have that power. They have that privilege. They enjoy such kind of privilege. And this privilege is known as the absolute privilege. Next is the abuse of process. So abuse of process means using legal process, file a case or a complaint only to harass someone. It is a punishable offense. So a person has not committed a crime, but against that person you have filed a complaint. So in order to harass that person, you have done so. So that process, that is a punishable offense. If you do that, then this is called the abuse of process. You are abusing the process. Now, next word is the acceptance. Acceptance, this basic term we use in case of the law of contracts. Law of contracts, you know, in law of contracts, what happens? An offer comes. Yes, a party makes an offer and another party accepts that offer. And in that whole process, in that whole process of the contract, yes, there is no unconditional things are attached. Means that must be unconditional. No condition must be imposed on that thing. So a deal is being finalized. So when a deal is made, so one party, he makes the offer and another party accepts that offer without, means that deal will be executed without having any condition imposed on that particular deal. So this is all about, this comes under the law of contracts. So this is the general term we use, that is an acceptance. Next is an accident. Accident is a very common term we use. Accident means that is not an, we don't know when the accident will happen, when it will happen and where it will happen. So it is an unforeseen thing, an unintended act which cause injury to another person. A person is generally not liable for injury caused by the sheer accident. So accident is an untoward situation, means something is going to happen and no one knows where it is going to happen, when it is going to happen. That is an, no party is known that. No party know that thing, when that thing will happen and where that will happen. That is an accident. Next word we have, that is an accretion. Accretion means addition of something of value to an immovable property due to some act of nature. For example, earth added to a person's after a flood. So if I give an example of accretion, this is an A is a person, he having some agricultural land, and what happens? Flood comes and the sedimentary soils gets deposited on his agricultural land. So he will get benefited by that because of the deposition of sedimentary soil, what happens? The fertility rate of his agricultural land increases. Means some value has been added to his immovable property. Here agricultural land is an immovable property. So in immovable property, some value is being added, an addition of something, and that thing is done by the act of nature. This is the very important thing, because this flood is not a man-made flood. It is a natural thing. So it is an act of nature. Because of that act of nature, in an immovable property, something is getting added. Something of value is getting added. So that is an accretion. That term is an accretion. Next and the last word for today is the accused. So whom we will call the accused? A person who is alleged to have committed a crime when the first information report is lodged with the police naming a particular person as an offender, he can be said to be an accused. The accused is tried, either punished or acquitted by the court. So what happens with the accused, whom we will say? So someone has committed a crime. A is a person. He has committed some crime. So in that case, what will the victim? The victim will do what? The victim will do what? He will lodge an FIR with the police. FIR, that is called first information report. He will lodge with the police. So after the FIR is lodged, what will happen? The police will go and search for the offender, and he will arrest that offender. And now he will be tried in the law of court. He will be tried. And after investigating the whole things, the judge will either give the punishment or he will be acquitted. If no guilty is been proven, then in that case, he will be acquitted by the court. So that person is called an accused person. So that's all for today. If you like the video, please subscribe, share with your friend, and also you can make this thing, you can get many videos like this, legal terms, and in this way, it will help you to crack the exam. Thank you very much.